built. I would probably eat normally at the 90 because it's closest to my dorm and I'm lazy and I don't want to walk all the way over to Champs.
The place that I eat most on campus is Starbucks just because the location is very convenient and it's just a really quick and easy place to get a good snack.
I eat at Champs most because it's right across from our dorms. I'm in Blazers, so it's just convenient to eat there.
It's probably Cookout just because it's really, really cheap and it's good food. It doesn't necessarily make you feel good after eating it, but it makes you feel good while you're eating it.
I eat at Champions and Taco Bell most of the time just because it's close and better.
They have salad bars in the dining hall, but then there's also like Freshy and like other places where you can like use your flex dollars, which have healthy options.
So there's not very many healthy food options on campus. And they're all very expensive if there aren't.
There's really not many options, and the salad is like the only option, and it's always soggy and gross.
A healthy vegan option's at Freshy, but it is more expensive. They're tumbling down, and they didn't even put up a fight. They didn't even make the sound. I found a way to let you in, but I never really had.
Big Blue Pantry started in 2014 as a student organization under the Center of Community Outreach by a single student that really wanted to. The CCO had a lot of funding, and that's how it started. The university gave them a space in the basement of Whitehall, which is where we still are.
Yeah.
So it's been open for about 6 years now, and every single year there's like a new director and a new PSET team who controls the marketing, advertising, making sure that the pantry stays stocked, donations. To actually run the pantry, to have the hours that we do, there's 2 to 3 federal work study students who actually staff the pantry, and then we also have an advisor who advises and then helps manage the pantry. A lot of people actually come to us for donation drives, so like we just had one from like a whole accounting class or like the College of Education. The sororities are going to be doing a donation for all of us. Our big thing is Big Blue Harvest, and so that's like our big like marketing thing. So anyone can take a free item Tuesdays from 9 to 12.
I think eating healthy is pretty important in college because if you don't eat the right amount, your body's just not going to operate right. Neither is your brain. You're not going to be able to function. You're not going to be able to operate right in the classroom either.
Gotta be like a 9 about how successful you are, because like the freshman 15 is a thing, but if you gain like a little more than that, then you just feel a lot different and it's gonna affect your studying habits and stuff.
A 10, because I believe healthy eating enables your brain to think quicker.
And I think it's a 10. It's super important to eat healthy because then you'll just feel better and then you can like do so much better in your classes.
It's a 10 out of 10 because feeling good is great and feeling good gets good grades.
So there was a survey that came out in 2017. That's where I got those statistics about the food insecure students at UK. And food insecure students actually had a whole point GPA drop from people who weren't food insecure. And so you were obviously seeing like a lot of mental signs too. Food insecurity is just like basic malnutrition. So like even though someone doesn't look like hungry per se, they could even be overweight, that malnourishment can cause like long-term detriments, both in like your health, your mental state, and you know, just the way you perceive yourself.
If you're a student on campus at UK, you have to get a meal plan if you live in the dorms. And the problem with that is not everyone likes the food there. Not every place has the quality of food that some people need. And they end up losing more money than they do saving money.
I think I would save money if I didn't have a meal plan because they're just so expensive, and then I can like go get whatever food I want and make it on my own.
I would save more money if I did not have a meal plan because I do not use my 10 swipes every week since I go to the grocery shop more than I go to Champion's Kitchen.
16.7% of adults are food insecure, but that's about 1 in 3 children in Kentucky. And I use Kentucky just because, you know, it's like 60% of Kentuckians come to UK.
Yeah.
And so you have to imagine like these 1 in 3 children that all of a sudden have no support from families, or at least financially. And so couple that with like the rising cost of tuition, housing, I don't know, just the basic cost of living, and food kind of comes last. I do think that the university does a great job They've really provided Big Blue Pantry with everything that they need. They've helped us gain a corporate sponsorship with Kroger. We're able to keep the pantry stocked that way. I think they had a basic needs coordinator who anyone can come to and make an appointment with, and she can actually help with grants and things like that, which I think is really important. Other than that, I think it's definitely awareness that these things exist, and like one cafe, for example, where you can get lunch for $1. All these things just need to be advertised more.